Chiunque di noi, soffermandoci sull'argine di un torrente,
whoever stands on a riverbank can notice how water moves according to a random, apparently irregular motion, generating vortexes of various form and size. The same happens when we stretch out on a lawn to watch the clouds on a windy day. Water and air are fluids. When a fluid acts chaotically and irregularly, we call it turbulence.
Irregolare viene chiamato turbolenza. Gran parte delle aziende aeronautiche.
Between the wars, the majority of aeronautical companies built some hypergean systems to be able to make aircraft in case of a time of war. They mostly made tunnels through the mountains. The former Caproni industries of Pradappio represent this kind of industry. And the tunnels they made stand as an ideal place to host a facility apt to study turbulence.
Ciclope nasce nel 2015, proprio.
Ciclope was born in 2015, right inside Caproni tunnels. The idea was to create a research facility, namely a wind tunnel, to be used by different research groups coming from all over the world to make trials and use the instrumentation at their disposal.
Utilizzare la strumentazione a loro disposizione.
There is a very unique facility that becomes a magnet to bring people, to attract people to come to do the research and provide answers for very important open questions. They impact fuel economy and saving energy, safety, and many other aspects, all related to turbulence.
Alla turbolenza spesso viene data.
Turbulence is often given a negative connotation, being often associated to typhoons and tornadoes, that is, natural disasters. Whenever we travel on a plane, we are used to hearing a voice saying, "You are kindly requested to fasten your seatbelts, as our plane is passing through an area of turbulence." In some of his drawings, Leonardo da Vinci revealed his keen interest in issues related to turbulence. Since then, a number of other famous scientists have spent plenty of time focusing on this phenomenon. Despite such a strong commitment, the issue of turbulence is one of the few problems of physics that are still unsolved.
Fisica ancora non risolti.
Il problema della turbolenza è che noi.
The problem with turbulence is that we do know equations, but we cannot solve them, not even by using the most powerful calculators available worldwide. Therefore, what we usually do in this case is a trial that, theoretically, may give us the answers we are looking for. In fact, this is a bit harder than that, as we can surely recreate conditions in our laboratories that are similar to the real ones. Yet, to recreate such conditions does not mean to be able to do measurements. Therefore, we could develop increasingly smaller instruments to follow the resulting vortexes, but the matter is we would have to stop at some point, otherwise we may lose measurement accuracy. The philosophy we adopted in this laboratory is that of making it larger.
Quella di rendere il nostro laboratorio più grande.
This facility is unique also on a European level, but also I would say worldwide. It's doesn't exist, something like that doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. And it's very nice to have this facility because it makes it possible for European researchers to come and collaborate on turbulence research. And also I know that there have been people also from outside Europe coming to do experiments in cyclone.
The laboratory in Pradappio is quite unique because it's inside a mountain, so the conditions are quite stable. They don't change because of temperature or noise, and also they're quite unique because of the size of the tunnels, the pipe size almost 1 meter, the pipe length which is almost 130 meters or so, you could not do somewhere else.
It is a closed-loop wind tunnel, so we can say that the air flowing inside the tunnel is always the same. There are systems to keep conditions steady inside this circuit and, most of all, to create the initial conditions we want. This pipe was aligned with utmost accuracy, as even a minimum curvature would produce disturbing effects.
In questo modo.
So in that way, what could we offer to the scientific community in the future? Not only turbulent models, but also monitoring techniques for strength and friction, which are the main cause of consumptions and, consequently, of emissions. there would be the economic and financial advantages, but also environmental ones. Finally, there would also be new measurement techniques and new sensors. Thanks to the cooperation with other universities and laboratories with facilities like ours, we're working on the same issues.
Lavorando sugli stessi problemi.
This is a facility that will take many years to bring all the fruits of the results. I'm sure you know, for example, in CERN, near Geneva, there is physicists that have been working on the same facility for many years, and sometimes it takes 1 or 2 years to produce results. And I think it's very significant that the University of Bologna has provided a home for something that can be of a big scientific and practical impact.
Si creano.
These atmospheres can really offer an occasion to exchange ideas and approaches to work as well, working modes, on a same scientific issue, but can be seen from different points of view here, given the number of people dealing with the issue, i.e. those involved in the research group. But also given their different backgrounds and everything takes place, so to say, here at home.
A casa nostra.
Un famoso aneddoto nella nostra.
A famous anecdote in our scientific community has it that Heisenberg, Nobel Prize for Physics in 1932, on his deathbed made a wish to meet God, to ask him two questions. The first being, why relativity? And the second one, why turbulence? Heisenberg was optimistic about God being able to answer the first question. Certainly, Ciclope was not born with the ambition of answering Heisenberg's question. What we can do, on the other hand, is take baby steps towards a better comprehension and modeling of this most complicated phenomenon of physics.
Di questo complicatissimo fenomeno fisico.